So if we that more automation in the assembly, so not only the automotive but also some field. So that in the assembly field, it required some of part is robotics that like automation, some of part human skill required. That is really mixed field. Then so I think that the assembly application is more beneficial for interaction between more human and robots.
Collaborative robots, to me, are getting away from the idea that you build the environment for the robot and then the people are sort of peripheral around it. Imagine if you wanted to put robots in McDonald's and say, well, first you completely rebuild the way McDonald's is set up, then you put the robot in, then that's going to be a very long adoption rate. I see it more as robots and people being close together. And if there are people around, it means it's an unstructured environment. It means things move around. So the robot, and this is why we can do it these days, is again processing and sensors. The robot can sense how the environment has changed. It doesn't need to be down to some millimeter accuracy because the robot's going to adapt to it.
Right.
And that, to me, is a big part of collaborative robots, that it's not the clean, pristine workspace, but it's the workspace where people are. And once you have people and robots in the same workspace, the robot doesn't have to be 100% perfect.
I think the fact is the awareness of the manufacturers now. There's more collaborative robots coming on the market. There's a change in dynamics with the cell phones, the wearable technology, and there's a need for it now. So people are saying, hey, how can I fix my problems?